This video covers the basics of the CL bar pusher, why it's important to prep your bar stock, and when to re-grease the piston seal. This is a manual load, pneumatically controlled piston that automatically pushes your bar stock. The piston will locate the bar stock by using a conical live center. There are bearings that allow the bar stock to spin while the piston remains stationary. When a G105 activates the push command, air is supplied at 35 psi through an air regulator in the lube cabinet. After the regulator, air flows from the solenoid in the lube cabinet to the regulator on the bar pusher. Air then flows through an orifice past the retract switch and then to the end of the piston. You can use the black lever on the bar pusher to manually move the piston forward. Air will flow from the air regulator in the lube cabinet to the manual forward switch, through the air regulator on the bar pusher, to an orifice passing the retract switch, and then to the end of the piston. The piston will push the bar until it hits a stop, so you will need a repeatable stopping surface, like the face of a tool holder. The collet will then clamp the stock, and the machining process will begin. The machine will stop once the number of parts commanded to run has finished, or the end of bar switch has been triggered. The inlet to the end of bar switch is located on the middle of the piston. The actual sensor is located inside the lube cabinet. The end of bar pressure sensor is nothing more than a pressure sensor connected to a cross-drilled hole, pictured here. While the piston is still pushing the bar stock, the sensor is exposed to ambient air. When the piston reaches the end of its stroke and all you have left is a remnant, the piston seal will pass the cross-drilled hole. The sensor is then exposed to pressurized air, and this is how the machine knows you've reached the end of the bar. When you press the retract switch, air at full line pressure blows across an orifice, creating a vacuum, pulling the piston back to its original position. Placing a 60-degree chamfer on your bar stock will help keep it centered and is absolutely necessary if the bar stock diameter is larger than the live center. Remove the piston bimonthly to check the seal for wear and reapply grease. Thanks for watching, and until next time.